Hi, I'm Gaylerd. Welcome back. Hey, now that you've got your first song challenge under your belt, it's time to pick up the pace and do one that's a bit more challenging. This is a song that was written back in the 60s by a Catholic priest by the name of Peter Schultz. It's called They'll Know We Are Christians by Our Love. But if you're thinking this one's going to be boring, you better sit back and think again. Because in this song challenge, I'm going to give you some ideas for adding wow factor riffs, fills, and transitions to the intro, the verses, the bridge, the chorus, and the ending. And once you hear it, you're going to want to be adding your own wow factor and playing it over and over and over again. So I'll go ahead and play through the entire song for you and throw in my version of wow factor to give you some ideas on how to get your musical juices flowing. Then you and I will take a closer look at each one of those five parts. And finally, you'll try your hand at personalizing wow factor into the entire song. So get your pick, get your guitar, meet me back in the studio. I'm going to show you how to put wow factor into They'll Know We Are Christians by Our Love.
We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord, we are one. They'll know we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love. We will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand. We will walk with each other, we will walk hand in hand. And together we'll spread the news that God is in our land. They'll know we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.
Okay, so let me go ahead and show you the chords to this song. It's an easy three-chord song. You've got an E minor, an A minor, and a C. Now, I've got two other chords that I throw in when I do the break in there. The break is not really in the song. I throw that break in there because I think it sounds cool, but it's not in the song. And I'll show you those chords when we get to the break. Just a couple more chords in there. Right now, let me show you what we're going to do for the intro. Okay, now I'm going to show you what I'm doing for the intro. Now remember, you can copy these licks right now for practice purposes, but you're going to want to just take what I'm doing and embellish it. Make it better. Make it your own. All the notes that I'm using for all of these riffs are the fretboard notes for each one of these chords. So if you don't remember them, just go back and review those tutorials that show you the riffs and transitions for the fretboard notes, okay, for the E minor, the A minor, and the C. Make sure you get those down. That's all I'm using in those. So here's what I'm doing on this intro. I'm going to go ahead and imagine that I'm playing by myself for an audience. I wanted this song to sound really cool, so I want to get a little percussion in the background, but I don't have a percussionist. So what am I going to do? I'll just scratch the strings for a beat or so, And then I'm going to get into a little quick little lead intro. And all I'm doing on that is a little hammer-ons and pull-offs on the 4th, 5th, and 6th string. And I'm using it to get down to my first chord, the E minor. So my riff is going to be like this. Okay? And that gets me to my E minor. So let me show you this. If I'm doing a scratching, now listen to that beat. That's an open six, then a second on four. And it's all E minor fretboard notes. And all I'm trying to do is get a little bit different transition. I don't want you to hear the same old beat, so. Like that. Okay, so let's go ahead and try that and we'll get into the E minor. Do that scratching a couple of times. You can do that with however many times you want, and then you go right into the first verse, and it says,
we are one.